एवरीबडी, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 2 पार्ट 3, दैट इज इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्पोरोफाइट। सो इंटरनली फर्स्ट पार्ट दैट इज टीएस ऑफ स्टोलन, इंटरनली इट इज डिफ्रेंशिएटेड इंटू इपिडर्मिस, कॉर्टेक्स, एंडोडर्मिस, पेरिसाइकल एंड स्टील। सो फर्स्ट वी सी फर्स्ट पार्ट आउटरमोस्ट रीजन दैट इज द इपिडर्मिस। इट इज द आउटरमोस्ट सिंगल लेयर ऑफ रेक्टेंगुलर पेरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स। द सेल्स ऑफ द आउटर वॉल आर क्यूटिनाइज्ड। देन इनसाइड द इपिडर्मिस देयर इज द कॉर्टेक्स। The outer region consists of thick walled cells which are compactly arranged layers of lignified cells forming hypodermis. The inner region is formed by thin walled parenchymatous cells which are loosely arranged with sufficient intercellular spaces. These cells store food. The innermost layer of cortex is called endodermis. Endodermis is made up of rectangular thick walled parenchymatous cells. Then next part, that is the stele. It is single and protostelic in nature. It consists of solid columnar of vascular tissue without pith. It is externally surrounded by pericycle made up of 2 to 3 layers of thin walled cells. It consists of single vascular bundle which is conjoined, concentric and amphicribal as xylem is surrounded by phloem. The xylem is star shaped with metaxylem in the center and protoxylem radiating towards the periphery. Such type of protostele with stellate or star-shaped xylem is also called actinostele. The xylem consists of tracheids and xylem parenchyma. The phloem consists of phloem parenchyma and sieve cells, which completely surrounded the xylem, but more prominent in between the radiating protoxylem groups. Okay. Then next point, that is internal morphology of rachis. So see here, when we are take the transverse section of rachis, internally the rachis is differentiated into epidermis, hypodermis, endodermis, pericycle and vascular bundles. So first we see epidermis. Internally the rachis is differentiated into epidermis, hypodermis, endodermis, pericycle and vascular bundles, that is the stele. So first point, that is the epidermis, which is the outermost single layer of rectangular cells with cutinized outer cells. Then hypodermis. Ground tissue is differentiated into the outer zone of thick walled, compactly arranged without intercellular spaces and lignified cells forming hypodermis, which is generally seen in this figure. It gives mechanical support to and strength. The inner ground tissue are parenchymatous, thin walled, loosely arranged with intercellular spaces, and they contain starch grains and chloroplast when young. A layer of the ground tissue surrounds each vascular strands. Vascular system consists of 2 to 3 vascular strands embedded in the ground tissue. They are arranged in horseshoe shaped manner, open towards the groove. Each vascular strand contains a single vascular bundle surrounded by its own endodermis. and pericycle. Each vascular strand consists of single layer of parenchyma, therefore they are known as a meristem. The vascular bundle is conjoined, concentric and amphicryble or hyacinthic, as xylem is surrounded by phloem. Xylem is exarch, C-shaped or coma-shaped and consists of tracheids and xylem parenchyma. Vessels are absent. Phloem is made up of sieve cells and phloem parenchyma. Sieve tubes and companion cells are absent. Then next point, internally, that is leaflet or pinna. When we are taking transverse section of pinna or leaflet, the TS of pinna or leaflet shows upper epidermis, mesophyll, lower epidermis and sorus. So first we see upper epidermis. It consists of single layer of compact arranged brick shaped cells with chloroplast and outer wall is keratinized. It is distinguished by the presence of hydathode as shallow depressions above veins ending and absence of stomata. Mesophyll. It consists of spongy tissue containing one type of cells. Therefore, pinna is said to be isobilateral. However, the upper spongy tissue are more compact than the lower one. It also shows vein ending in the lower one. It also shows vein ending in the form of group of tracheids below the hydathode. The third part, that is the sorus. Sorus remains attached to the lower epidermis at the vein ending and consists of placenta, sporangia and endosia. Placenta is a cushion-like structure which is made up of thin-walled parenchyma. It provides nourishment to the developing sporangia. Sporangia are present on either side of the placenta. Each sporangium consists of a stalk and capsule containing spores. Endosium is a protective covering which is single layer. It is attached to the placenta by massive short stalk of parenchyma cells. Okay. Then, thank you.